This is a continued discussion from the previous episode of Nose to Tail, a podcast where we explore the world of aviation lifecycle solutions, insights, and more. Presented by Jet Midwest.
If you're replacing yourself, that brings some sort of mentorship into your life. And I know for me personally, that's been really fulfilling to be able to bring people through our system. Talk to me a little about the journey that you take at Genesis with somebody, and maybe if they're taking on accounts, or, you know, what process are you guys kind of following to handle that handoff, and how you handle maybe those individuals as they take that journey?
One of the things I love about working here is that when Santi was alive, he was always appreciative, and Mahdi is the same way. I always, when I'm training for travel and for accounts, my door's open to anyone. If it's someone in the shop that sees that incoming is down and they have a question, they know they can come in my door. Sometimes the mentoring is very, very connected to education, and I'm still learning things and they take care of me. I feel that being as transparent as possible with employees and answering questions when they ask them is probably the best way. And we share information and we educate. And after Santi died, Mahdi and I had a conversation. She talked to me about what her vision for the company was, which mine was exactly the same, and it's to empower the employees to do the best that they can do. And if they need training and we don't have that in-house, then we go find it. We have an incredible team here. There's a lot of mentors, you know, and we see employees mentoring each other.
You said a couple of things there that are pretty poignant. The first one is you talked about being transparent, and by bringing in those folks maybe who are more boots on the ground than managing with the customer, but oftentimes the knowledge base really lives in their hands. They really understand this. And that's a very hard thing from an upper level management standpoint to really grasp. A year or year and a half ago, we actually opened up at Jet Midwest a rolling action item list. And we brought every employee in the company, didn't matter what job you had, every employee in the company came in and we sat down with them and we said, listen, everybody's got access to this. If you have anything that's stopping you from doing your job, no matter how small it is, how big it is, how strange you might think it might be, we want you to go on, click on the link, enter your information in there, and then the leadership will get together every week and we'll discuss those things and find ways to get rid of those obstacles. Because sometimes people, especially if they've been around for a bit, they go, well, you know, I kind of complain about this thing every once in a while, but no one does anything. And then they just stop complaining. Well, it's still a problem. And it's not fair to that person if their manager is not hearing them correctly. It's not that they're being ignored, but oftentimes managers have a lot of things on their plate, and so it doesn't maybe get the attention that it deserves. We said, we're going to put it on this platform, and it's not punitive. In fact, we want to hear the problems, right? We can't jump in and help if we don't know about them. So we kind of opened this up for our team, and I think it was really successful for us. We had a whole lot of items come through in that first, say, 9 months or so. And some of them were quite big things, like whole departmental changes, and we kept on top of them. And some of them were small things, like cell phone cameras that our receiving department had. The software was maxed out, and we needed to update and get a different phone so that they would be imported into our system. They built their own solution, which was a workaround to slow them down.
Nice.
And also, he's like, well, you mean I could just spend a couple $1,000 and solve this problem? Like, yeah. I go, send in the requisition. Let's get it approved.
Right.
So you're correct. Like, bringing that whole team in, I think, has made our company better. And it also empowers those people. And it's important. Mm-hmm. They're talking to the entire top of the company, seeing these things, and their voices are being heard. And I've seen an emotional change in a lot of those folks who've been able to get their voices heard. And they feel really, really included in that process. As you guys work on team building, what's some of the things that you guys have done that really stick out as impactful?
I'm pleased to say we've had a perfect storm of RFPs recently. And, you know, you don't have a department that does that, but everybody's doing their checks now. And we're like, holy cow. And people say, well, it's not really fair that they do this. And I said, it's the business. You know, we're excited about it, but it's crazy. So we have an ice cream truck coming in Monday to let everybody know we appreciate how hard everybody's worked on typing up those 100% kits for those RFPs. And I go around and say thank you, too. But We, on our 30th anniversary, which was in May, Monty rented out an arcade. Oh, and the guys were all revved up and ready to get in those go-karts. Let me tell you, they were squealing wheels. And we do those things, and we do a gala. I mean, we have had things where we had specific things to accomplish, to build teams. But I really like it when we have time for, well, for example, the bowling last night. Anybody can come. And I might not have wanted to go, but if I want to show that I'm as committed to you as I'd like you to be committed to Genesis and to each other, then I need to be there. I work for a company that has a female principal, CEO, president, a female COO, a female CFO, a female VP of administration. So we had to throw Wes in there as the chief production officer so we'd be balanced. And it wasn't by design. It just worked out that way. And we don't run around saying that's what makes us good. What makes us good is the people that work here. And when people say things to me, I go, no, 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 no. It takes everybody in this building. Everybody. We just try to plan things where we can all be together and have conversations and get to know each other as people. And I love seeing how all of us interact with each other, even and outside of the shows now. And building your network is like building your team within your walls. You got to get that team outside your walls as well.
So, Sandra, is your team growing? Is Genesis growing? Is your headcount going up?
It went way up. We had 40% growth. I'm so proud. I mean, I know it's Maddie's company, but I'm proud too. You know, I'm proud of her. I'm proud of how she stepped up when Santiago passed away and the whole world thought we'd fold. We showed them. Everybody thought there was a fire sale. And they kept sending them to me, and I go, we're not for sale. We're not for sale. We're not for sale. We're not for sale. And now the trend is investment. You know, people invest and right. want to invest in, and so I'm answering those calls. But we're family owned. And so I think we're going to probably stay that way. We grew 40%, and we had at one point, I think, 72 employees. So we're small to mid-sized shop. Now we're down to 62. I don't know if we're just doing it better, but now we are at pre-COVID sales.
That's good. So I like to ask all of my guests what their favorite aircraft is and kind of why. Some people it's related to the journeys they get to take on them. Others it's, you know, something related to the job they do every day.
I'm going to have to say it's a 747. I think I understand her better, and I think that she's been the workhorse. I know that's changing, but she's been the workhorse in this industry for so, so long. And whether it was getting on one to go across the ocean when you're going to be an exchange student and it feels like the biggest thing you've ever been in.
That's pretty awesome.
You know, and we're mostly a Boeing shop. We do some Airbus, but I love it when I get on an airplane and people hear different noises and you go, it's normal. And they just look at you like, who are you?
That's fine. It's fine. They got a backup plan.
Yeah. It's like, yeah, but I like the prop planes too. They're Dash 8. Yeah. I mean, it's small, but, you know, we go from Greensboro to Charlotte in those sometimes. So, yeah. But
it's a different noise level.
It is. Right? It's a different story. And people go, there's propellers on this thing. Are we safe? And you get, you're fine. You know,
but well, that's awesome. Well, I could have guessed based on how the interview went that you probably that soft spot for the 747, which, listen, I can totally understand.
Well, it's my career. You know, they've been my career. Yeah. Now we're making sure everybody knows this is my lad, okay? We do other aircraft.
Yeah, you know, it's interesting. So I cut my teeth early in my teardown career was on MD-80s. It was probably the biggest, the MD-80s and the Fokker 100s. Those were big markets for us.
We still see some of that now, MD-80s and MD-11s, yeah.
Most of that purpose behind all that was because it was just the cheapest thing out there and I was broke. So it was
easier
to buy
retiring.
One of those, anything mm-hmm. else. Mm-hmm. So it was interesting as we moved from where we were previously in Kansas City up to the overhaul base here at KCI. Yep. And all of a sudden we started bringing in big airplanes and you should walk up to this, you know, whatever. DC-10 or a 777 or a 747-400, it is just an unbelievable feat of engineering if you think about the 747-8, that aircraft, you know, maximum takeoff weight is just under a million pounds. Yeah, it takes off and flies for, you know, 12, 14 hours, sits on the ground for a couple more hours, turns around, does it again. And it's just, it's pretty amazing technology. So I can see why you have such a passion for that aircraft. Not so sure about the Dash 8. I've had some Dash 8 journeys in my career.
Not a favorite, but yeah.
Now, if you would have said, you know, G550, maybe I was like, a little airplane. But well, Sandra, is there anything else maybe that you'd like to enlighten people on about either Genesis or aviation in general that we want to add on to this?
We need to do a better job, and I'm not going to get into all that, but we do mentorship programs, and we work with the local technical colleges, and we have those conversations and all of those things. But we don't compete for business with many people around here. But Marshall and Boom are in our backyard. So we'll be competing for resources. So we've got to get young people interested in this industry. We've just got to. And I just wish that we could take what we know and impart that to young people and have them take pride in being part of something that drops supplies when they're needed, that picks people up when they're needed, that rushes people out of war-torn countries, and look at the difference that we make. Plus, it's a really cool industry. It's a lot of amazing people, and the jet fuel gets in you. It does get in your blood.
Yes. Yeah,
I've had it on my arm before too. Wasn't fun. They were pouring milk on me. But I think that we can be proud that we're aviation strong.
Yeah, there's certainly a lot of passion that comes from being in aviation, mm-hmm. really having that kind of get into your system, and there's a lot of fun and there's a lot of hard work for
yes.
sure. I mean,
yes.
if you want to mm-hmm. get in this business and not work hard, there's not really a spot for you. And I would agree, you know what? I love aviation's ability to bring people together,
not
just within the business, but you think about what we've done to the globe mm-hmm. and travel, you know, certainly coming from a U.S.-based, we're in Kansas City, right in the center of the country, and, you know, road trip to 9, 10, 12-hour road trip, that's pretty routine. Like, it's no big deal. You know, we have employees that drive north of an hour just to get to work every day. And they love it because they don't mind being in their car because it's
right.
sort of
That's
different
me.
Culture.
Yeah.
But, you know, again, aviation is literally it makes the world that much smaller,
yes.
right?
Yeah.
It makes the world smaller when I know I can get on an airplane. I don't have a ticket. I could buy a ticket right now. I can be through TSA pre-check in 1 hour. I can board an airplane from right now to head to Chicago or Dallas mm-hmm. or Atlanta. And they can make that and accommodate that. And it'd be a good journey. So certainly, I love what aviation has been able to do. And you're correct. The mentorship and what we need to do to nurture the excitement level around the whole world related to the aviation industry, whether it's in what's coming, right? Is are we going to go towards hydrogen fuel? Are we going to have some
right.
sort of biofuel?
Right.
I'm not sure. Are we going to have pilotless aircraft at some point flying passengers? Is someone going to come up with some fantastic, they're going to come up with some fantastic design.
Oh, they are. Yeah, they are.
Some single wing designs. There's all these great ideas that are out there. And we've got this awesome generation whose technology and use of AI and these different things, they're going to be able to achieve some of those
yes.
things that I can't even – I needed help to turn on the video today, right? So for all of the stuff that we do, that generation is the one that's going to take us that next leap. And you're correct. We just got to keep them excited about what the real mission is of aviation in and of itself, you know, safe, reliable travel and providing our operators with the services so that they can provide that to the client who's flying wherever they happen to be flying that day. So, well, thank you, Sandra. Everybody from the Nose to Tail podcast is listening. I'm sure they've enjoyed all of the conversations and banter that we've had here. You could certainly look us up on LinkedIn because I know Sandra and I are both big-time LinkedIn folks. So thank you, everybody. Signing off.
Thank you for listening to our podcast, Nose to Tail. Please like and subscribe to our channel. Presented by Jet Midwest.